I disagree with you. I don't think Reimer is at the stage in his life and at his age to be a backup goalie. I think he's got a chance to be a starting goalie. And I agree with you on the first portion of your editorial that the Leafs, for the last 5 years, 6 years, are habitual pinchers, and they leave their goalie to take 35 shots, average to 40 shots per game. And when you have that amount of shots on a goalie in one of the fastest professional sports in the world and the best league in the world, which is the NHL, you're going to get goals scored against you, no matter who you got in net. And I think that Reimer played well last night, very well. And I think that Reimer, what impressed me the most about him last night, that he was focused. And some great side-to-side saves. And I see him this year with a much more amount of confidence, great reflexes, and great lateral movement over last year. And I think that Smith played a great game up until the goal that he got scored in between his legs. He became completely unraveled from a guy who was totally playing the third defenseman. Incredible passing, incredible control of the puck when he was getting the puck and passing it up to his defense or wingers. I think that the Leafs had a sparkle of hope as being at least a competitive team last night, Billy. A sparkle. I'm not going to be a bona fide Leaf fan where I rationalize and justify every game that they're going to come back and be great in the Stanley Cup. But I think that there was a sparkle at the 11th minute of the third period where they looked like they were coming back, Billy.
Well, I can tell you this, Frank. Every game they have played this year, they have played with pride and distinction. They have not been beaten badly. They've lost a few, obviously. But when you look at the two Montreal games, the first one and the one last Saturday, two bad goals in both games cost them the game. And that was their number one guy in net. And last night, I thought Reimer's one, if it was a bad goal, it was that short side goal, the third one, scored by the kid from the Blackhawks that came in on the Vermette deal. But that wasn't a factor. Reimer made enough great saves to keep them in the game. So I'm not disputing Norm's classification of Reimer as a backup goalie, because backup goalies can be very helpful. But I can tell you this thing, he ain't no backup to Bernier. Bernier has not established himself in spite of everyone in the Maple Leaf organization trying to spoon-feed him into being the number one goalie. He spits the bit out every time the coach puts it in, whether it's Babcock or whether it's Randy Carlyle. He doesn't like it. It doesn't taste good. And God only knows he's had a good chunk of it.
Well, I think that the prime example is what you just alluded to, that Randy Carlyle sacrificed the confidence and the credibility of Reimer and put everything on Bernier. And Bernier keeps tacking and keeps choking. And you're very bang on. I think that he cost all those games with those soft goals. And a soft goal, any professional hockey player will tell you, breaks the back and the will and the energy of the fucking team and the story.